is none like you. No one else can touch my heart like you do. And I could search for all eternity long and find there is none like you. There is none like you. There is none like you. There is no one else. No one else can touch my heart like you.
Jesus,
Lord, I choose to leave your name.
After eating her money,
And you think you just go like that before Jesus. It explains the reason as to why some people have problems in their marriage. What you saw in your life time before you get married are the fruits you will reap when you get married. Say amen. Sisters, likewise. Amen. If you're not sister, you're not ready to get married to the brother. Stop battling the brother for money for new fashion of hair. You know, there is a new fashion that came. This one you've never seen. Poor brother thinks this is really serious. He gives money. Look at your neighbor and say, let us get well saved. Speak it seriously and say, let us get well saved.
You'll
be telling God that you know I I got another God, so take up for me to come, I must, you must first take away this one. Everyone is busy. There's no one who is not busy. Even God is busy. But if he can spare his time to come and be around the presence of his people, if God can spare time for his people, what about you? The man of God declared and said, 2014 is the year that marks the door that introduces us to the light, to the latter days. The last days. Praise the Lord. Every opportunity you get to be in the presence of God, treasure it so much. If you can sacrifice time for other things which do not add so much value to you, about time for God. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
If you can sacrifice a whole service to go and work, look at me and say, I know you would love to mind you. Let's go to the Word of God. Those who have ears should hear what the Spirit does. What? God takes great pleasure in the prosperity of his people, but both spiritually and physically. Listen to what Paul said. He prayed for the Ephesians. For this reason, I kneel down before the Father, from whom his whole family in heaven and on earth derives its name. I pray that out of his glorious riches, verse
16,
he may strengthen you with power through his Spirit in your inner man, in your inner being. Praise the Lord. So that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power together with all saints to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is love and the love of Christ. And to know this love that surpasses knowledge. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Yes, yes.
It seems physically, it's like these guys had made a lot of progress, but their progress was only up to the limitation of the physical measure. But spiritually, they were still found wanting. So he says, for this reason, he goes down on his knees before the Father. And what is his prayer? He prays that these guys may be strengthened in their inner man. Because he realized, if they were not strengthened spiritually, it would be very possible for the physical to replace the spiritual. Praise the Lord. The same way we feed this physical man. There is a demand from our spiritual man to be fed. One of the reasons as why we come to church to be taught the Word of God is for our spiritual man to be nourished and to be fed with the Word. them, in a day, how many times do you read your Bible? Or ask them, do you have any time to read your Bible anyway? It is wrong. It is a red abomination for you to spend 1, 2, 3 hours in a church and remain unchanged. It is wrong. Look at your neighbor and say, how old are you spiritually?
There are certain spiritual levels